Weekly Reflection with Sonia Rodrigues. Today is Wednesday, the 27th of October, 2021. We are going to reflect on the Gospel according to Luke chapter 13, verses 22 to 30. Let's open our hearts and listen. Jesus went through one town and village after another, teaching as he made his way to Jerusalem. Someone asked him, "Lord, will only a few be saved?" He said to them, "Strive to enter through the narrow door, for many, I tell you, will try to enter and will not be able. When once the owner of the house has got up and shut the door, and you begin to stand outside and to knock at the door, saying, 'Lord, open to us,' then in reply he will say to you, 'I do not know where you come from.' Then you will begin to say, 'We ate and drank with you, and you taught in our streets.' But he will say, 'I do not know where you come from. Go away from me, all you evildoers.' There will be weeping and gnashing of teeth when you see Abraham and Isaac and Jacob and all the prophets in the kingdom of God, and you yourselves thrown out. Then people will come from east and west, from north and south, and will eat in the kingdom of God. Indeed, some are last who will be first, and some are first who will be last." The Gospel of the Lord. I recall a story of two children of an alcoholic father, where both grew up watching him being abusive, uncaring, and selfish. As it turned out, one child grew up to be an alcoholic worse than his father, while the other one became a doctor who swore to find a cure for alcohol addiction. How did two diverse outcomes arise out of the same situation? The difference was in the choices made by them. One son played victim and succumbed to the circumstances surrounding him. The other son refused to let circumstances get the better of him. He chose to go against the tide, overcame negativity, and emerged victorious. We have been given the freedom to exercise our will, so our life is a summary of our choices and their outcomes. Perhaps we should pause today and reflect on the choices we make and where they lead us in life. In today's Gospel, Jesus urges us to strive to choose the narrow gate. The Gospel of Matthew throws more light on this by explaining that the wide gate is easy and there are many who opt for it, but its path leads to destruction. On the other hand, the narrow gate leads to a difficult path that has few takers. However, it leads to eternal life. To simplify this, it is basically a choice between right and wrong, good and bad. So if the narrow gate leads us to our eternal destiny, that should be the right choice to make. However, Jesus says today that many will try to enter but will not be able to. He knows it is not an easy choice because it involves challenges and sacrifices. The wide gate opens to the many false charms and temptations of the world. In an attempt to satisfy our unceasing material desires, it is very easy to go with the flow, to fit in, and to make choices aligned with the world. We might even put up a false facade to project a clean image. But if our heart is not in the right place, it does us no good. As James reminds us, whoever wishes to be a friend of the world becomes an enemy of God. The way of life through the wide gate may offer us worldly power and position, as well as security and satisfaction. However, it is short-lived and it distances us from our Creator, who on Judgment Day will say to us, "I never knew you." How then do we make the choice to follow the difficult narrow path? By simply being aligned to Him and to His Word. In John 14:6, Jesus says, "I am the way, the truth, and the life. No one comes to the Father except through me." In Psalm 32:8, He assures us, I will instruct you and teach you the way you should go. I will counsel you with my eye upon you. And in the lovely Psalm 119, we discover how His word can become a guiding light and roadmap to always make the right choices in life. When we truly love God, following His commands becomes a natural and joyful process. Each time we find ourselves at crossroads, having to select between conflicting options, we must evaluate them by referring to the Word of God and decide accordingly. This can often be a tough call, but we have the Holy Spirit within us who strengthens our resolve to lead holy lives, even if it means going against the world. So when in doubt, let us pause and listen to His voice that whispers, "This is the way, walk in it." Let us pray. Dear Lord, we thank you for giving us your precious word and the gifts of the Holy Spirit to guide our choices in life. We pray for the grace and strength to abide by them as they often go against the enticing ways of the world. Help us to remember that with you we can do all things. We ask all of this in your mighty, holy and precious name. Amen. God bless you.